Tonight's meeting is actually, we're having a meeting about the 2013-2014 budget, which we now open to adjourn and then move on to our regular agenda. Now turn to Dr. Sly, the presentation, 2013-2014 budget.
Thank you very much. And tonight, we are having a public hearing on the proposed budget. We will go over revenues, expenditures, and all the steps we're going through and what we expect to happen. I believe all materials are out in the back, so if anyone doesn't have any, please help yourself. Everything will also be on the webpage, and we will be then reproducing these in volume to send out to our staff and our community. All right, thank you. Anthony, if you want to begin.
The public hearing is a requirement of law to occur within 14 days of the budget vote. Our budget vote is 2 weeks from tonight, May 21st, so this is the earliest we can do the public hearing. There were some open issues, revenue sources that were far from guaranteed when we met the last time, specifically additional state funding through either lottery spin-up or other state funds. We have reviewed our budget and have recommended reductions in expenditures if we are not successful. There is still movement on the Senate bill being introduced, but we are cognizant of the chance it will not pass. So we have put together a list, which I believe is also available for the public. We tried to make the cuts as far away from the program as possible, but there were cuts to staff. I'll specifically note two nurses are being reduced in the budget. There are central office reductions of $400,000, which include both computer, BOCES, and central office staff. This is above the $150,000 that was noted last time, which primarily came from attrition, not filling a position. And the other area that directly affects children, there will be a reduction in sports program. We will still have varsity sports. There will not be funds for JV in this budget. And clubs are reduced by $75,000 also. Those specifics have not been determined, but I'm sure will be based on numbers that are in the various clubs trying again to affect the least number of kids. Busing related to those two areas were also reduced. We did reduce one mechanic. We feel that with the reduction in our bus fleet, there's a normally a 18 to 20 vehicles per mechanic. We would be keeping with that. We would still have six mechanics, which is that also counts our B&G vehicles, school lunch vehicles that we own, as well as our buses and vans. There will be enough for all for that maintenance. We did budget two contingencies in BOCES. All the students that are right now planned for BOCES special ed placements are in the budget. However, it is nice to have two contingencies. Obviously, new children move in. Right now, those contingencies are removed. That was another $130,000. We tightened up areas like health insurance, TRS, FICA, software. The cut there still means that we spend up to the state allocation in textbook software, hardware. We did keep the iPad program in the budget, but of the areas that are now interchangeable, the feeling was that we would not be spending all the software money anyway. Race to the top is picking up some more expenditures, and that is the primary list. We did get a firmer feeling on retirements of teachers and civil service retirements, and we obviously booked those. Clearly, if we get $3.5 million from a spin-up, these will not be what we return to the budget. Most of these, a lot of these are innocuous. We would look to return programs that most directly impact the most kids as possible. That also includes, if we are successful with getting more federal funds, Obviously, we lost positions through sequestration and reductions in Title I. So those would also be areas we would look to try to maintain with additional funds. With that, so the budget that is still being presented is a $209 million budget. If, again, we are unsuccessful in securing additional revenue, we will only spend $206.4 million. These would be the areas that, once we post the budget, we would immediately do an appropriation adjustment just to reduce certain lines so that we have budget control on a $206.4 million spending plan. But we're hoping we can spend more than that with revenues coming in above what we are estimating. And with that, I can answer any questions.